One of my favorite movies to watch, plain and simple, is Get Out. My wife and I love Jordan Peele movies. From Us to Get Out, some of the best. I just love them. And I'm going to tell you why I love them so much. Because after your hour and a half experience in the movie theater, what we do is we go home and we're going to YouTube and we're going to find out all the hidden meanings within the different scenes that are going on throughout the movie. Because you just know what Jordan Peele is going to be, something hidden behind the scenes, and it all ties together to something else. And I love the pursuit of thinking through the meaning behind the movie. And I think that for you and I, we have to find ourselves going back through the last couple of scenes of our lives and saying, what is the meaning behind the mess? You know, it's nothing worse than going through a hellacious season in your life where you're facing difficulty and you're in the battle and the fight of your life, and you've been through it for the last 6 months. You're going through it for the last month, last year, but you don't get the meaning beyond the mess. And I think that you and I, we have to become experts of going through and dissecting for ourselves what the last season meant. Now, what I mean by that is sometimes we want to say, you know, God put this sickness on me, or God made me go through this because he trying to teach me something. Yeah, sometimes we just make dumb mistakes. Sometimes it is a spiritual attack that comes against us. Sometimes it's just life, man, and it ain't got nothing to do with God trying to teach you a lesson. Some lessons are just learned, simply put, because you're wise enough to be a person that goes and reflects and processes what just happened to you in your life. And I want to give you an example of this. If you read the book of Proverbs, for instance, Proverbs is like, you'll hear Solomon saying, I was sitting in the window and I was looking out over the people. And he's just processing. He's processing what's going on. And yes, God illuminated some things and gave him wisdom, but he had to sit himself down and process life. He's like, look at the ants and consider their ways. I mean, he's like looking at an ant mound and processing. In other words, there's this thought of, I pause to reflect. I pause to think and process and understand things. And if you want to be a person who grows from this level to the next level to the next level, and your situations and circumstances that you have gone through aren't wasted time, because I'm all about not wasting my time, reclaiming my time, then you got to become a person who is a thinker. You know, you sit down and you get a pencil and paper out and you just say, man, what in the heck did I just learn from what I just went through? That was crazy. I ended up in the hospital. My kids lost their mind. My spouse, I wanted to kill him, but I didn't, because God kept me. He didn't let. And after you process all that, you say, what did I learn about myself? I learned that I may be impatient when it comes to dealing with crazy people. I may have learned that actually I'm a really, really, really generous person, because even though I didn't have that much, I was willing to give a whole lot to help out other people. Or you may learn that you need to set some boundaries, man, because there are some folks who continually take advantage of you, and you keep finding yourself bailing out people that don't have your back when you're going through situations and circumstances in your life. If you don't learn these lessons, you're going to be going right back around the same mountain until you become a wiser student of your own life, of your own circumstance.